everyone. Welcome to my channel, Tiny and Tidy. I'm Vishali and I'm determined to motivate you to get your messy, disorganized space nice and tidy. Are the toys in your home taking over your entire space? Do you feel like you have to move simply to house all of these toys? Well, hold off on the house hunting until after you watch this video. I have 3 kids and that comes with a lot of toys. I figured out a system to keep the toys in our 850 square foot condo under control. If you follow these 3 steps and the tips that I'll be sharing today, I guarantee you that you'll also be able to do the same. So make sure to stick around till the end of this video because I'll be sharing a freebie that I know you'll find useful. Now don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below because I'll be posting a useful video just like this one every single week. I'm a teacher and I have taught elementary school for over 10 years now, and I've also spent some of that time in kindergarten classrooms. So I know that imaginative play is extremely important for development. So as much as you probably want to just toss all of those toys, that's not a good idea. But the first thing you should do is sort through all of the toys and determine what you need to keep and what can be donated. Step 1 is to sort and purge. Categorize the toys, and as you do this, throw away whatever is broken and make a donation pile for the toys that you no longer need. What I did with my donation pile is I sent most of it to my parents' house because they babysit a lot, so then that way when the kids go there, they have a whole new set of toys to play with. Here's a list of possible toy categories: puzzles and games, planes, trains, and automobiles, dolls and accessories, books, arts and crafts, balls, dress-up play, kitchen, blocks and Legos, baby toys, musical toys, animals, and stuffies. Now, this is just a suggested list. Your list might be a bit different. It really depends on the type of toys that you have in your home. Step 2 is to organize. Now that you can see how many items are in each category, you can use appropriate bins and baskets to hold all of the items. One mistake I made when doing this was that I got colorful bins. This was a big mistake because I live in a small space and our living room is also our playroom and the kids' bedroom is also the playroom. We don't have a designated play area. So by having colorful bins, it made the living room look extremely cluttered and disorganized. Kids' toys are already so colorful, so really you don't need any more color. What I would recommend you do is get neutral bins or baskets and use that to store all of their toys. It'll help make the space look less cluttered. Step 3 is to label. Now I know that your kids probably can't read these labels, but it'll help you make sure that you put everything back. And while you're putting things back, always remember to show your kids where everything goes so that eventually they start to put it back themselves. Now to keep all of this under control, I make sure that I'm very clear about the following. Number 1, I avoid having birthday parties because I don't want a ton of toys for the kids. Instead, we'll go to a place like Great Wolf Lodge and celebrate by having a fun family experience. I am considering having a combined Fiverr birthday party this year. So basically, I'd like to combine their birthdays because my kids were born in September, October, and November. So then we would have one big birthday party instead of 3 different ones. And then a Fiverr birthday is basically, instead of guests bringing gifts, you would just let them know that it's a Fiverr birthday and they would only bring $5, and then I would use that money to buy each kid one present instead of every guest bringing every kid a gift, and then we have so many gifts to deal with. But I'm still thinking about the whole Fiverr thing. I don't really know how I feel about it, but let me know in the comments down below. Have you tried it before? What do you think? Do you think it's a good idea or not? Please comment down below and let me know your thoughts. Another thing I try to do to keep the toys under control is I try to let friends and family know that we do not want gifts for our kids. Now, we'd rather they spend time with them, and if they really want to give them something, then perhaps give them movie tickets or tickets to the zoo or something like that. I also avoid buying too many toys for the kids. Instead, I'll give them experiences or consumables. Another thing I try to do is I rotate through the toys, and then that way they won't get bored with the same old toys all the time. And my last tip would be to make sure that you continue to do a toy edit. And what that is every few months you have to go through all the bins and start removing toys that they're not playing with, because otherwise it will get out of control again. And there you have it, guys. That's how I keep my playroom organized and under control. If you like the tips I shared in this video, follow me on Facebook and Instagram because I'm constantly sharing useful tips and tricks all about small space organization over there. Next week, I'm going to be sharing my top 5 kitchen organization solutions. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell if you want to be notified when that video is posted. And since you've stuck around this far into the video, I'm going to share a freebie that I know will truly help you get your playroom more organized. In the description box down below, you'll find a link to my free guide all about playroom organization. Don't forget to hit that like button and share this video with someone that you know would find it useful. And if you like this video, be sure to check out one of these ones. I'm sure you'll find them useful too. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and happy tidying. Bye!